Hello, my name is Bas Cartigny. I work as a teacher and information specialist at the Wageningen University Library. In this presentation, I will discuss three methods to find scientific information. These methods are called search strategies. For this presentation, I will assume that you already know what you are looking for and where you are going to search for it. As stated, three search strategies will be discussed. Firstly, there is the simple search, also called a quick and dirty search. In this method, you only enter a few relevant terms in the search bar of a database and see if anything relevant turns up. The second method is following a thread. This is also called snowballing, where you find new publications using ones you have already found. The third search strategy is a systematic search. In this method, you aim to find all relevant scientific information on a topic. This is achieved by identifying the main building blocks of your topic. These building blocks are called concepts. The next step in a systematic search is coming up with multiple terms that describe each concept. The terms of each concept are then cleverly combined in a search query. We will start by discussing the second method, following a thread. You can use following a thread when you already have one or more highly relevant publications. You can then snowball from one highly relevant publication to multiple new relevant publications. For example, you can look through the reference list of the relevant publications and find new publications that might also be relevant for you. The relevant paper you already had is probably also cited in other papers. Databases like Scopus, Web of Science, and Google Scholar make it possible to find these cited by papers as well. In these databases, you can find a list of all publications that cited your publication of interest. The publications you find in the cited by list are always newer than the initial relevant publication. Be aware that if you choose a publication that was published just last month, you will not find many cited by publications in the list, as the publication process of new papers that cite the publication of interest takes a few months. Now we will continue with the other two search strategies mentioned, the simple search and the systematic search. To explain the simple search and the systematic search, we will use an example. Imagine you are looking for information on how farmers cope with natural disaster. A simple search only uses a limited amount of terms. So I could start a simple search by entering natural disasters and farming in the search bar. The and between the words indicates that both terms have to be in the result. With the simple search, you get 108 results. This is already a decent and manageable amount. And a lot of people stop searching at this point because they think they have enough material already. And you have a decent amount, but you also missed a lot of possibly relevant publications. And by providing a little more effort, can find many more relevant publications. And this brings us to the next method, systematic search. In a systematic search, you identify the main concepts of your topic. For our example, we can use the concepts natural disaster and farming. The next step of a systematic search is adding terms to each concept. For example, adding synonyms, different word forms, and related terms. This will already increase the amount of results greatly. Here you can see that by adding just a few terms, we already get an impressive 12,000 results. This amount of results is probably too high for you to handle, though, as no one can really read 12,000 publications in a reasonable amount of time. An exception to this, however, is when you are doing a systematic review. Then you really want to find all the literature that is available on a topic, and you have to make the time to process all these publications. But for you, this is probably too many. And then you have to specify your research question. You can specify your research question by adding a different concept. In this example, I'm especially interested in the effect of natural disasters on income, so I added the concept income to the research question. For this concept, I used the terms income, livelihood, and poverty. Adding a concept is a reliable way to specify your research question. This reduces the total number of results enormously. Other ways to specify a result can be applying filters to your search results. For example, you can restrict your search to the last 10 years or to a specific country or region. Another option is to make one concept more specific. For example, you can zoom in on one specific type of disaster, like drought. Note that removing relevant search terms is not a valid method to reduce the amount of results. By removing terms, you will find less results, but you will also lose a lot of relevant publications. Only remove terms if specifically those terms are giving you a lot of irrelevant results, for example, because it's a very broad term. It takes time and patience to build a good search query like this, but it is also a very efficient way of searching compared to a series of simple searches. Furthermore, it is repeatable, and you can reuse pieces of the query for another research question in your project. In this presentation, three separate search strategies were discussed, but you will probably use them all at once in the same search process. As a final remark, I would like to mention the need to be critical when you are searching. Always check if the search system is performing your search in the way you intended it, and if not, find out what causes this unexpected behavior. If you want to learn more about search strategies and how to build your own search, please have a look at our e-learning modules, Orientate and Prepare, and Search and Evaluate. Good luck with your searches.